Now that the UN has been informed, it is up to them to decide how seriously to treat this threat and what action should be taken. Given the major international attention the Ukraine crisis generated, it's possible China will face a similar level of condemnation, but it's also a possibility that this doesn't happen, because unlike the Ukraine crisis, this is a two-way dispute. China claims Taiwan as their own and vice versa, and the historical unwillingness to recognize Taiwan as a legitimate nation could mean their cries for help fall on deaf ears. Our reports suggest Chinese military buildups have been detected in the cities of Guangzhou and Xiamen.
The statement from the Chinese Communist Party reads, "The accusations from the Taiwan Authority and the United States that we intend to launch a military operation in Taiwan province are untrue and unjust. We reject these claims and suggest the United Nations take their information from more historically credible sources. The U.S. government themselves haven't responded, but we do expect them to, given the CCP have accused them of being involved in Taiwan's claims. The United Nations have responded to Taiwan's claims, saying, 'We are treating this matter very seriously, and the People's Republic of China should be aware that the United Nations wishes to avoid unnecessary military conflicts.' Given Taiwan is not a member of the United Nations, it's not clear what their response would be to a Chinese invasion."
The Taiwanese government have released this photo, which they claim shows a convoy of Chinese forces transporting supplies to the port city of Xiamen in preparation for a military operation in Taiwan. China have not acknowledged this yet, but it does seem that China's denials, like Russia's at the start of this year, are feeble attempts to hide an obvious truth. What action the United States and the rest of the world will now take are anyone's guess, but it is clear that the world is once again left trying to avoid another war over territory.
China has built up its military significantly. It's got real capabilities to overwhelm Taiwan if left alone. And there's real doubts in China's mind about America's willingness to come to Taiwan's aid. They look at what's happened in Afghanistan. They looked earlier at what we did with the Kurds, the red line in Syria, how we didn't respond to Hong Kong, how we didn't respond to Crimea. So there's a lot of people in China who think there's a major opportunity. So I would essentially say we need to be much more explicit about our willingness to come to Taiwan's defense. Our allies in the region, Japan, Australia, and others, are expecting that, want to see that. And I much prefer to deter China through certainty, through specificity, through clarity, rather than leaving this up to ambiguity.
U.S. intelligence have reported a further buildup of Chinese troops in coastal regions near the Strait of Taiwan. The U.S. government have released this statement: "Our intelligence has detected an increased military presence in regions close to Taiwan in a manner that is consistent with protocol for preparing for quick, large-scale military offensives. We urge the United Nations to act quickly to prevent another invasion conflict." However, there does seem to be some doubt among experts as to how far the U.S. should push in seeking to avoid conflict.
Perhaps the most dangerous thing we would do would be to say, yes, we will under all circumstances defend Taiwan, but then not have the capability to do so. We might tempt China to take that action today rather than postpone it till the future.
This issue is not simple. Geopolitics never is. But all we can hope is that we find a peaceful resolution.
我们的情报发现了一些从中国大陆驶往该国的海军舰艇。现在似乎很清楚，对这个岛屿的袭击迫在眉睫。因此，您应该立即开始准备。我们相信，从广州和厦门出发的中国军队将登陆彰化县和云林县。如果你在这些县，你应该撤离，特别是如果你在沿海地区。目前尚不清楚中国军队将如何对待平民，疏散失败可能会杀死你。警方将引导您到安全的地方避难，直至另行通知。
Many places around the world are now waking up to the disturbing but unsurprising news of China's invasion of Taiwan. With the world seeing plenty of reports of China preparing for this invasion over the past couple of weeks, this outcome is unsurprising. First, reports from Taiwanese intelligence of an increasing military presence in Xiamen and Guangzhou. China denies these claims. However, this photo is soon released by the Taiwanese government.which they claimed showed a convoy delivering supplies to Xiamen in preparation for an invasion. The U.S. then officially accuses China of plotting an invasion and the U.N. is forced to officially respond, but ultimately opting to do nothing. This invasion could end in multiple ways. China's military budget is $230 billion, Taiwan's is $17 billion.This war could end in a powerful show of China's military might or be yet another example of a smaller nation coming out on top against a bigger neighbor. What we know is that ships were launched from Xiamen and Guangzhou at 2 a.m. local time, with ships making landfall in the eastern regions. It is not known how they plan to take the island, but the end goal is clear. A full seizure of Taiwan.
This meeting will cover the current events regarding the Sino-Taiwanese conflict currently unfolding. Those present should be aware that this information is protected under Title 18, Section 798 of the United States Code and the disclosure of this information to unauthorized persons will result in a severe criminal penalty. We have obtained intelligence that suggests China had intended to take Taichung City, Taiwan's second most populous city within 36 hours. This hasn't happened.Taiwanese citizens have ignored their evacuation orders and have so far maintained a solid defense of the island. Their only significant gains are islands part of Penghu County. This is good news for us. We must maintain and strengthen our resolve. Make China look weak. We must assert dominance and reaffirm our position as the global superpower.
The UK, France, Australia, and Canada have all backed the US's public condemnations, but none have committed to military action so far. This decision is not without logic. The Russo-Ukraine war was expensive and tiring, and China are a different beast to Russia. Victory will not come so easy against them, with them being the second wealthiest nation on earth. Germany so far have avoided any condemnations, seemingly trying to keep their heads down.Without Russian oil imports, their energy security is poor and they are vulnerable. They have decided they simply cannot risk putting a target on their head. The issue is clear. A disjointed international response only benefits China.
Taiwan 线，这里是中国。放下你的武器，否则我们会开火。你有直到晚上十点。台湾省，你抄吗？
罗杰，
你有不到十分钟的时间，你会投降吗？
我们有一条消息给你，来自总统本人。
它是什么？
去死吧。
Tensions are now rising within the EU. France and a handful of other prominent EU members are pushing for an official condemnation and sanctions against China, whereas Germany and other weaker EU states are clearly less willing to take such action. The EU is unable to function when divided like this, and attempts are being made to find a resolution. In contrast to recent years, France have found an ally in the UK. The initial hesitancy from France and the UK ended with the massacre in Taichung and have now committed to military aid in Taiwan. The European bickering has to end soon if China are to face a coherent international resistance to their invasion.
加在软件时请耐心等待。感谢您的出席，您提供的代码不应与任何人共享，不遵守将导致不公开的惩罚。美国现已进入台湾省周边海域，这是对这种情况的明确和直接升级，因此我们必须谨慎而果断地采取行动。 少数几个利用这个机会建议我们退缩并屈服于美国欺凌策略的军事领导人受到了相应的惩罚。如果人们在您所在的省份表现出类似的异议，您有权采取任何您认为必要的行动来阻止它。我们必须保持对我们亲爱的领袖的力量和支持感。谢谢。
We have received reports from China that in 16 of their 23 provinces, protests of differing sizes have occurred, and the Chinese authorities have attempted to crack down on them. A whistleblower has come forward and informed us that police were instructed to show no mercy in handling protesters.
They knew people would be against the wall, and they gave us shields, batons, and tasers. My chief told me to round protesters up and throw them in jail. If they tried to fight back, we were told to hit them into unconsciousness and drag them into a cell. Some of the police had silenced pistols, so the sound of gunfire wouldn't make the crowd angry.
China has never been a country known for liberty, but recently they have become more authoritarian. A major crackdown on the free press and of information on the internet, and the recent lockdowns to enforce their zero-COVID strategy has left many feeling trapped and oppressed. Maybe this war will be the tipping point.
The direct U.S. presence near Taiwan, China have become notably less aggressive. The USS Purveyor has not fired a shot yet, but it seems to have startled the Chinese enough to give Taiwan some reprieve. Taiwanese forces have begun reclaiming land in the north of the island, and Taipei remains well in Taiwanese control. In the south, there has been less resistance for China and they have made good ground there. With less troops now being sent to the island, Taiwan will be able to gain some momentum. China also has another issue. Domestic instability. Protests are emerging, particularly in Hong Kong, and the authorities are not holding back in their attempts to crack down on them. It remains to be seen if they'll focus on maintaining the war effort or domestic stability.
这是中国当局的官方公告。本公告将提供您在法律上有义务遵守的说明。不遵守将导致法律后果。随着最近中国各个城市的骚乱，我们采取了新的措施来防止在我们的街道上出现这种可怕的野蛮行为。现在已经实施了全国宵禁，从晚上7点到早上7点，您必须待在家里。不遵守将导致刑事定罪。此外，主要城市将由军队直接管辖。 您将毫无疑问或拖延地遵守他们的要求。如果您的城市受此约束，您将通过短信收到通知。对进入主要城市的车辆和人员进行搜查，拒绝遵守将导致刑事处罚。执法部门可以自由搜查他们想要的任何住所。反对将导致刑事处罚。这些措施旨在保护您和您的家人免受破坏我们伟大城市的不人道的野蛮人的伤害。 遵守这些措施符合您的利益，感谢您的聆听和再见。
The U.S. has begun lobbying NATO and the EU to quickly implement economic sanctions on China for its invasion of Taiwan. We believe that France, the UK and Canada are on board with this, but Germany and a collection of smaller states are not. The U.S. did expect this, however, and we believe that they will make financial assurances to these countries as an incentive, in order to mitigate their fears over losing Chinese trade. If these sanctions are confirmed, then the renminbi will likely plummet, as the ruble did in February.
We have intelligence that suggests China are facing major domestic issues. The sanctions, now widely implemented by the EU and NATO, has caused major economic instability, and the frustration from that and the ongoing authoritarian measures has led to brewing civil unrest. The decision to implement these rules seemed to have backfired, with Hong Kong, Shanghai, Zhangjiang, and Wuhan in particular seeing major civil unrest. We are also now aware of a newly formed organization called the Chinese Liberation Front, a growing militia that seeks to overthrow the current government. We believe they may be a useful asset in ending this conflict and causing major damage to the power of the Chinese Communist Party. The President has agreed to the Black Book Fund Protocol.
The
女人和儿童并插上美国国旗，他们不再隐瞒他们全面统治和压迫世界的计划。中国政府将继续抵制法西斯主义，为维护。这是来自中国解放阵线的信息，你的注意力很重要。不幸的是，中华民族陷入了混乱。中国共产党已经决定放弃任何道德，并使用极端暴力和残暴来镇压异议人士。 我们很清楚，他们的意图是屠杀持不同政见的团体，并实施全面的军事统治。政府害怕抵抗，不会阻止他，但这行不通。他们动员了我们，他们只是少数。我们是10亿，我们不会再服从这个转政了。我们将拥有自由，我们将拥有和平。加入我们，成为有意义的事情的一部分，为中国争取正义和自由。我们希望您做出正确的决定。
我们注意到，全国23个省都出现了针对政府的抵制。
有些是和平抗议，其他人则成为游击队民兵。警方在使用武力方面表现出犹豫不决，因为他们害怕使情况更加严峻。我们还追踪了从河内运来的武器，我们相信新的中国解放阵线正在准备发动军事进攻。
没有必要担心，我们的军队足够强大，可以将他们从地图上抹去。派几个营，听他们尖叫和燃烧。他们是一个可怜的群体。如果需要，我们将启动对中国的全面净化，以恢复纯洁和平衡。
这太荒谬了，而且几乎是不可行的。中国解放阵线在城市地区的影响力正在迅速增长，这就是为什么自播出以来内乱急剧增加的原因。我们必须认真对待他们。
这些该死的美国人，他们必须在这背后，否则他们怎么会成长得如此之快？他们的资金从哪里来？
目前这无关紧要。本次会议结束，远离市区。
来自海防的货物正在运输途中，我们预计它会在2点前到达。到达河内后，我们将开始取得进展。我们有什么？枪、火箭发射器、手榴弹、防弹衣，足够供应约15000个。
南宁陆团塞拉，你抄吗？罗杰，你有什么要报告的吗？不，这里很平静。优秀的。
派出援军，他们在这儿，他们在这儿。
你好，
先生，我们收到一条消息。
完他。
This is the USS Purveyor. Cease your offensive on Hainan, or we will open fire on Xiamen. You have until 5 p.m. local time.
让口译员听。
紧急情况，紧急情况，紧急情况，请撤离，请撤离，请撤离。香港目前正遭受军事袭击，您的生命处于直接危险之中。现在这里是战区，警察和救援服务将试图帮助平民撤离该地区。你应该毫无疑问地听从他们的命令，不这样做可能会导致您的死亡。留在这里不是一个选择，这是一个活跃的战区，请立即撤离，请立即撤离，请立即撤离。
这是我希望你传递给习本人的信息，他应该知道这一点。中华民族失败了，这是我们自己造成的。当我们决定压迫自己的人民并接管整个世界的那一刻，我们失败了。我们给了我们的人民决心、愤怒和决心，让政府垮台，为我们剥夺他们的自由而战。不要幻想他们会赢得这场比赛。当我们把我们的人民视为放牧的羊，为精英的利益而屠宰的牛的那一刻，就是我们决定命运的那一刻。我自己的行为是应受谴责的，我向所有我错了的人道歉，为此我会付出生命的代价。再见。
USS Purveyor, this is the USS Dempsey. The fleet is approaching the strait. ETA is in our tops.
Copy that.
This is the Chinese Liberation Line. You've been surrounded. Our information to the Chinese government is very simple. Now, just give us this city. Otherwise, we will be on the road to Beijing without hesitation, tear it apart with all the other cities. If you want to avoid unnecessary damage and pain,那就投降吧，我们期待您的回复。
这是中国政府的官方公告，请注意。我们已经承认中国解放阵线的条款，并同意停火，等待他们的正式回应。经官方回应，我军将撤离厦门。如果你们的部队向我们开火或越过你们当前的领土，停火将被违反，我们将进行报复。我们希望您能合作。
This has been a long and tiring battle. For months, the U.S., the Chinese people, and the Taiwanese people have fought valiantly to defeat the oppressive Chinese government. In the end, we've won. We have shown that the people can and will resist oppression. But the fight is not done here. The people of China must go on and fight bravely to ensure they get the freedoms and rights they deserve as human beings. Our work here is done.But there is much left to be done. Thank you for your bravery and sacrifice, and goodbye.